AmityVille 1992 from Vinegar Syndrome's AmityVille collection. It's about time. It is literally about time. We're moving on with our cursed objects. This time it is a clock that an architect has picked up on his travels, brought back to his rather garish and strangely built home, and it promptly burrows itself into the foundations of the house and starts to create these weird time effects and horrible antics. The kind of things you would expect from an AmityVille movie. Now, this was another one that I had seen and kind of forgot mostly about. But again, it's another one that's really pretty good. Really pretty kind of fun in the way it tackles its scares and horrors. Feels a little bit like a TV movie with the way it's lit and staged. But it has some moments of real fun. Now, we have an almost family unit here. We've got the architect father. We have the wayward teenage son who's rebelling against whatever anybody's got, and we've got the teenage daughter who is just kind of by the numbers, typical kind of daughter-ish, and we have the ex-girlfriend who has moved on but still helps out by looking after the kids now and again, no mother, and we have these primarily four people within a lovely street who start to see strange and spooky things going on that just ramp up to something not quite right happening. Now, the father gets injured pretty early on and he's kind of bedridden and slowly starts to delve into madness while everyone else is taunted and teased by this clock, by it stopping time, by it moving forward in time, by just displacing people and toying with them in such fun manners. And it's a little bit of creativity in the way the place is designed. It looks primarily like a set, which it probably is, but the way it's designed, this strange, unusual layout of rooms, the unusual way that it uses lighting from blue and red tints in the background to really create an odd atmosphere, is all incredibly fun. The clock itself is another kind of silly addition to the cursed objects collection, but it adds to a lot of the fun of the movie. And there's some side characters that are really fun as well. Like, it turns out that the hero of the piece is the unexpected wayward teenage rebellious son who has a little bit more going for him than first appearances, and I like that aspect of the movie. I like the fact that he had chess games with an elderly neighbour who took him at his word and believed in the supernatural. And I like the fact that it ties into AmityVille near the end with some little models of the old AmityVille house in a really lovely way that was just kind of spooky and hair in the back of your neck raising way. And I liked the son and how he was blamed for everything that was going wrong in this street, of all the antics that were happening, and how he was trying to figure out what the hell was going on. There is, of course, some lovely effects in this, and I think my favourite one is when the teenage daughter suddenly becomes a vixen and tries to lure a guy down to the basement for some shenanigans, only to see him melt into a pool of disgusting ooze and go down the drain. It's a wonderful effect, really kind of practical and icky and just wonderfully well done. And there's a few effects like that, like the father's leg, which gets progressively horrendous and more pulsating and pus-filled nastiness throughout the movie, is a horrific image. AmityVille 1992 is a really kind of fun throwaway horror movie. It is one that gives you some interesting characters, some nice twists and deaths. There is one particular death that I really enjoyed where it sets up this long scene where you roughly know what's going to happen, only for that person to just evade it at the end and then kind of laugh at the fact they're evading it, only to be taken out by something we did not expect, which is just, it's kind of playing with the viewer and the expectations. And I kind of like the fact that I had these little touches going for it. AmityVille 1992 is fun, good addition. It's entertaining with some good performances. It's, you know, interestingly designed. And I'd say it's another winner from this set. I'm looking forward to moving on to the new generation to see what object that will be. And no doubt we'll be back with a review for that at some point soon. I'd love to know your thoughts on this movie. Let me know in the comment box below. I'll see you next time on Man V Film.